Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. We're expecting a good one in the Pac-12 today. Players going through their final paces before kickoff. Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming up next with Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I will see you at halftime.
Successful seasons, and today one of them will take home the Pac-12 championship trophy. Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Oregon tees up the ball as we get ready for the opening kickoff. He's to the 20. And he's tackled to the 32-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Throw incomplete, wanted his receiver.
That pass didn't look exactly right when it left his hand. Sometimes you don't get a great grip on the ball and it comes out a little wobbly.
See what you got.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 32. And down he goes at about the 43-yard line.
The Buffaloes always have guys that are near the top statistically, and that's no exception today. We're really looking forward to watching this kid play.
From their own 43-yard line, second down. He makes his way to about the 48.
That'll make it 31.
Mike 56.
Hey, check. Oklahoma. Hey.
He's going to come up short. Good tackle. Couldn't get that additional yard he needed to keep the drive moving.
No, he was trying to muscle his way past those big guys, but they stood their ground.
He doesn't want to touch back here. He wants to knock this ball inside the 10.
It's away. Short punt.
Sometimes it's not the huge distance, but precision that you need from your punter. Nicely done.
The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Tackle made right around the 24-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 35-yard line.
The option's one of the more difficult plays to defend. The defense went after the quarterback, which left the running back with plenty of room.
Goes out of bounds at the 38.
That'll make it 77.
51, Mike. Mike 51.
Here we go. Right, 80. Hold on. 80.
Nice run, and he's brought down.
Hey,
46. From the 46-yard line, it's second down. He gets rid of this one.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. He wants it all. Quick strike, and it's caught for the touchdown. And for Dixon, that touchdown toss gives him the team's career record in that department.
Here's just another notch in what's been an outstanding career. It's sort of hard to comprehend how good he's been for so long.
He makes the PAT. An 8-play, 85-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Caught at the 8. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. Oregon's in the driver's seat right now, but it's still early, Kirk.
Yep, very early in this game, but you got to love the feel for it as far as they're concerned. They came up with a stop, and then they get points, and right now they're out of the game.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Catches it, and he's punished. Tackled after decent pickup. Receiver, and he's taken down right around the 40.
It really wasn't badly played by the defense, but sometimes a good throw and catch just beats you.
Caught, open field, and he's level at the 45. The middle for a nice game. The defense is having a difficult time stopping this drive.
Right now they're doing enough to be in situations they want to be in, but they have to finish the job. And the plays start to add up, so we'll have to see if this defense starts to look tired out there.
Here's an opening. They'll bring him down right around the 38-yard line. Second and 10. Ball on the 38. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Brought down right around the 36-yard line. Gets it out in a hurry. Big catch there as they knock him out of bounds.
Well, they're living on the edge here a little bit, but, you know, they're converting when they have to. Seen. He's got to be relieved it wasn't picked.
From the 9-yard line, second down. And they make the stop at about the 11.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
Through one quarter, the Ducks with a touchdown lead. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. Puts it right in his hands. Touchdown.
They saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
We'll be tied with the extra point. And he hits the PAT. So a 13-play, 78-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
We get a tie game at 7-7. Bell from the 10. He's taken down at the 34-yard line. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. And he's tackled at the 49.
Decision that time. That was a pretty tight area he was trying to throw that one into.
From the 49-yard line, it's second down.
Here we go.
Tackle right around the 50. Here's an opening, and down he goes around the 11-yard line.
Well, the defense brought a lot of pressure, and that time they got burned. If you don't get to this quarterback on the blitz, you're giving him a ton of room to make a play.
He's going to try and scramble, and they get the sack. And for Butler, that sack was his fifth of the year.
He really fought to get to the quarterback that time. He's certainly shown that he can get it done on a week-to-week basis.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. Run there. Nearly intercepted.
Well, the quarterback's breathing a huge sigh of relief because he got away with throwing what should have been an interception.
This should be an easy field goal. Oregon is looking to go up by three. Kicks up, and he got it.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Simmons has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Makes a grab and steps out right away.
He faked out everybody in the stadium. When you can sell the run that well, you're going to have the upper hand on the defense.
Boy, was he drilled as he let go of that football.
Yeah, he's going to feel that one tomorrow.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. Got it. And he goes down quickly. Wants to throw outside. It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds. They come out in an empty backfield. He makes it to the 35-yard line.
Gain of one on the play. That brings up second and 9.
Incomplete. He was looking for the tight end. He tried to hit his receiver in stride, but overthrew it a little too much.
That'll come in time. Just repetition, throwing that same pass over and over, and he'll be fine.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 26. He delivers. He goes up and gets it. And he's all the way in for the touchdown. Touchdown grab number 2 in the game.
Well, it's obvious the coach wanted to get him involved in the game plan. It looks like it was a pretty smart move, too.
And he tacks on the extra point. A 7-play, 72-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
Brad, how about the guys up front? The offensive line giving the quarterback plenty of time to be able to read the defense and make the right throw.
The score now, 14-10. From the 5-yard line, he makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. Oregon's gotten the play out of their quarterback, and you expect that that was going to happen. But, I mean, what is happening here? Somebody else is going to have to come to the forefront, or this thing's going to be over.
If you would have told me before the game that this quarterback would have played like this through the first quarter and a half or so, I would have thought this team would have been leading this game. You're right. Something has got to happen where his teammates, the rest of this group, they've got to raise their game if they want to have any chance of winning this game.
From their own 23-yard line, second down. Made at the 39. Throws complete. He's got space to work. He's taken down at the 48.
The quarterback and his receiver make a great play here and convert on an early down.
Oregon's going to use their first time out of the half here. And there's 2 minutes remaining in the half. He's at the 40, and it's the senior. He's tackled at the 29-yard line. but he can't shake the defense. They come up to the line here at second down and 14 after the sack. Here's a quick throw. That's incomplete. He caught it, but failed to get that one necessary foot in.
That's an outstanding catch, and he just missed making a big-time play.
Here's the eighth play of the series. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a three-point lead with this extra point. And he converts the extra point. Let's throw it out to Reese now for a studio update.
ACC championship action. Yellow Jackets rushing attack can be difficult to stop, and they get into the end zone for a touchdown. The Yellow Jackets lead 14-7.
Separated by a field goal here, Reese, 17-14 in our game. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Smith has it at the 5. And he's tackled at the 19-yard line. Colorado's roaring back. And they're within striking distance right now.
Yeah, they've done a good job of kind of sticking with their game plan after a very slow start. Now you look up at the scoreboard, and right before the half, you're right back in the football game.
They moved the ball very effectively on their last drive, which ended with a touchdown. The defense has been talking it over on the sideline, trying to make some corrections. Let's see if they can stop them this time.
I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And the one thing is that any defensive coordinator will tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up. Try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
And he carries the ball for a nice game. At the 41.
That'll make it second and inches.
So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers. Screen pass. He's got his halfback, and he's taken down at the 44.
Well, that was a perfect time to call a screen pass there by the offense. The defense had pinned their ears down, and they were coming after quarterback. They were out of position. The quarterback waited just to the right time to drop it down to the running back for a big play.
Gets to about the 47-yard line. The Buffaloes are going to call their second timeout. It's second down, 8 to go. Ball on the 47. His man, and they take him down immediately. Five wide. And he's hit immediately. He gets rid of this one. From the 40-yard line, it's second down. Fires back to the tailback, but he can't bring it in.
These guys, especially in the secondary, really get after it and can make life hard for the play callers on the other side of the ball.
This is the 10th play of this drive. Trying to get it to the tight end, but it falls to the ground. Carter, he'd like to change field position with his punt. It's away, short punt. Dixon's ability at that quarterback spot, we all knew about that, Kirk. We thought he was going to have a good game. He's not disappointing us at all. We're closing in on halftime, and right now he's having an effect on the entire game and especially on his team.
Yeah, and Brad, he's really just sparked this entire offense, and I think his success has a lot to do with the momentum that this team's been able to enjoy. And this is exactly what the coaching staff had counted on, is his ability to lead this team and make plays like this to be able to lead them to a victory. It takes a special player to be able to do it, and so far we've seen that from him.
From their own 36-yard line, it's first down in the shotgun and five wideouts. They'll bring him down around the 47-yard line. And they're going to put six DBs on the field to counter that five-receiver look. Caught with room to work. And he's tackled in the open field. So at the end of the half, the Ducks lead 17-14.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. He's Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. We've been looking forward to this game all week, and it has lived up to billing. A close game. You feel like that it's going to be a great second half. And, boy, we've got the perfect guys in the booth. What a reward today for Nessler and Herb Street to get this game.
But, you know, it's not a secret, Reese. They get the best game every week that we think's on the schedule, right? So they got this game. It's great. It's close. It's going back and forth. I mean, what a treat to watch one of the best games of the year just unfolding in front of us. And, more importantly, to hear the silky smooth sounds of Kirk Herbstreit and Brad Nessler. Does it get any better?
David and I will be keeping an eye on your game and everything else going on in the country here in our palatial and comfortable surroundings in the studio. The best seat in the house belongs to Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin.
Anderson back to return.
He's pushed out of bounds right around the 26-yard line.
Well, this is a very competitive game. Just when you think one team has gained the advantage or the momentum, the other team comes fighting back, and it's going back and forth. This is almost like a basketball game.
So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Oregon is up by three. He has some room. He's to the 40. He's at midfield. He finally goes down at the 39. Brought down right around the 40. Scrambling. Ball is loose. Fumble. Offense falls on it. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 29. Quickly to the tight end, incomplete.
That makes it fourth and 12.
Let's see if he aims for the sideline and tries to get this thing down deep in their own territory. That was a nice little pooch kick right there.
That's why they made the decision to punt the ball right there. They wanted to pin this offense deep in their own territory. This team really trusts their defense.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Pass is caught. The defense lays him out. Love picks him up around 7 yards with that catch. And he throws right away. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down.
Mike 56. I got one.
And they make the stop, the 39-yard line. Tackled around the 48-yard line.
That brings up second and nine.
Mike 56.
And he stopped behind the line.
Loss of 4 yards. That'll make it 3-1.
Third down again. Out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
This is the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up fourth and five.
Bell is back deep to return the punt. Didn't get all of that one. Colorado's not going to back down from anybody, Herbie. I guess at least not today.
No, not today. They've played with a chip on their shoulder. They've stood toe-to-toe with the big boys, and I don't think they're finished yet.
So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around. Oregon is up a field goal. And they get nice yardage on that run. He's scrambling. And down he goes around the 42-yard line. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Runs right for a nice game. He makes the PAT. It was a 5-play, 73-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
And Brad, right now, the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running lanes.
So the score now, 24-14. Simmons has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. Schmidt fields it at the 2, and down he goes at the 22-yard line. They were forced to punt the ball away the last time they had it. They'll be looking for a little more out of their offense on this possession.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
Looks middle, got his back. Tackle right around the 24-yard line.
Miscommunication between a quarterback and a wide receiver right there. They need to get their signal straight.
Third down, 9 to go. Ball on their own 24. They come out on an empty backfield. Sends it out quick, intercepted. And he's level at the 30.
It's a nice first down by this offense. And you can see the wide receiver here carries the football. You're talking about a very versatile offense that's tough to defend and very unpredictable.
From the 17-yard line, first down. There he goes. He makes his way out to about the 9.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That'll bring up second and 3.
For a loss.
Loss of 3 yards on the ball. That'll bring up 36.
Don't leave yet, folks. We still got one more quarter to go. 24-14, Ducks. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. He's on the run. Runs with it, and he's got room. He's taken down around the 1-yard line.
They've obviously found a formula for moving the ball against this defense. Let's see if any adjustments are made before their backs are really against the wall.
They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Scrambling around, keeps it, and he's got a touchdown. Still a long ways to go here in the fourth quarter, but that score has certainly put them in a great position to win the football game. He splits the uprights with the extra point. A 6-play, 29-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running backs.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. Here's a step in the maturation of a young quarterback. How does he respond to throwing an interception on that last drive?
This quarterback can make good passes. He just needs to focus on not forcing the ball to his receivers.
They bring him down.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
From their own 18-yard line. It's second down. Throws incomplete.
I mean, he has his wide receiver wide open. You spend all those hours during the week to be able to get prepped and ready to go. You got an open man like this, just step and deliver and make the throw.
Quick throw. He got a hand on it, but it's incomplete. Carter is the punter. Bell takes it at the 47. He wasn't breaking that tackle. What a hit. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. The 44-yard line. 82 yards.
That'll make it second and seven.
He's at the 30. He's tackled around the 25-yard line. Inside the 10. Nice play to set up first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
Touchdown, Ducks. Tacks on the extra point. A five-play, 47-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out, that can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
They line up to kick this one away from the seven. So they're just about set to get the game going again. Throw onto the receiver, and he's taken down at the 34-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Roger, Mike 56.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. Throws, and that one's going to hit the ground incomplete. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 34-yard line.
556, 556. Set, Texas.
Nice run, and he's brought down. Kelly gains about 5 yards on the run.
That'll make it 35.
Gets rid of it. Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field.
Tight right, tight right. Go down, go down. Mike 56, Mike 56.
bounds around the 41-yard line. And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
And he tackles him hard at the 29-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 29-yard line. They'll bring him down at the 17-yard line. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. He gets out to about the 8.
That brings him second and 9.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and 1. The extra point. Let's get the latest now from Reese Davis.
The Hoosiers came into the game ranked 10th. After the hard-fought loss, will the pollsters keep them high in the rankings? This game was tighter than spandex on a sumo wrestler. And for Gorman, a great day running for more than 150 yards. The Hawkeyes take the W, 28-24.
And for Oregon, what big news that is. They've got a chance to move up in the polls now if they can pull out a victory here. Oregon to kick. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 25-yard line. Late in the fourth quarter, this game's not even close. It's a blowout. A lot of folks have already gone home. And, Herbie, I think we're going to make our dinner reservation. Carries the ball for a nice game. The Buffaloes will use their first time out of the half. From their own 30-yard line, second down. Brought down right around the 36-yard line. That was a 6-yard completion, and we'll have first and 10 coming up.
Heads-up play by the quarterback to find his receiver in traffic and get the ball into his hands.
It was a great read by the quarterback there to take the snap and throw it quickly to get the first. And they make the stop around the 33-yard line. It's second and 13. Ball on their own 33. Senior. He's tackled in the open field. Just a total lack of competition today. Oregon 45, Colorado 14. Kirk, go ahead and just give us your reflections on this game.
It's a really good job by the coaches here by not letting them take an underdog lightly and really getting after it from the very beginning of this game. Oregon played a terrific game today. Even better than I thought they would. Top to bottom, they just looked out of sight.
For the Ducks, they'll notch their 11th win in what has been an excellent season. And for the Buffaloes, they drop below 500 on the season with today's loss.